If there is a keyword in everyone's life, my keyword is running. Tangled within the relentless pulse of the metropolis, work and leisure converge, blurring their borders. The antique objects, wrapped in nostalgia and imbued with warmth, become remnants of past childhood memories. As they are revived one by one in Peng Nanku's short videos, the idea of visiting the craftsman from Xiangxi grows increasingly firm. The land beneath my feet is gentle and quiet. In this natural setting, Peng Nanku trudges, carves, and polishes, unveiling the origin process of ancient farm tools.
Who made Mojin tea? Please taste it.
Flavorful. Is that your handmade loom?
Yes. 10 acres of land, 8 acres wide. A weaving maid sits inside. One step of the foot and one pull of the hand. The loom clatters and hums. Miss Lee, have a try.
One push, one step. One pass, one grab. As I concentrate, I gradually become skilled.
The making of this item takes weeks of repeated trial. But failure is still a common occurrence. To understand the process, I often ponder until late at night. To seek out a master, I hit the road before dawn.
From a good thing, you can see countless failures. You interpret this statement perfectly.
This is another large item I made. Legend has it that Shen Nong cut wood for a plow and bent wood for a hoe. The design concept of the chu and plow comes from these two types of soil-turning farming tools. With the chu and plow, the cows will never tire again.
The chu and plow is ingeniously designed. When lifted, the plowshare remains shallow in the soil. When pushed, it goes deep.
Peng's craftsmanship in perfectly replicating them is admirable.
Well, we set up the filming base at the edge of the village. Sometimes after working for a whole morning, if the video is slightly unsatisfactory, the master will immediately start over. Some people say that the master is too meticulous, but I think one should be as meticulous as the master.
The growth of a craftsman is a lifelong arduous practice. To complete this practice, a craftsman must not be careless at all.
The labor tools were once indispensable tools for farmers to survive. Each tool became a personalized embodiment of each generation.
In this rapidly changing era, the craftsmen who quietly work in the rural areas are gradually fading away. And the spirit of preserving their crafts needs more young people to understand and inherit. Like a lamb, Peng Nanku has illuminated himself. The countryside and north to me. Now with this light, I want to go further. Life goes on, busy and ordinary. When I share Peng Nanku's story with my students,
the collision between ancient farmer's technique and modern short video create a brilliant spark.
Every item in the video has a voice, making more dynamic than the museum.
My classroom has undergone new changes, expanding beyond the classroom and textbook. I have enabled my students to immerse themselves in the rich and vibrant traditional farming culture of Hunan, to touch, feel, and experience it firsthand. Inheritance is an enduring topic in Huxiang culture. Hunanese mother has rooted the perpetuating spirit in her children's heart. With the inheritors, the native land is filled with warm and nostalgic feelings. With disseminators, the peace and warmth of the ancient farming civilization will never be buried or forgotten.